Hi, I am Anupama Narayanpur from Presidency School, Bangalore South. Today we will be learning about Java programming language. Java is a universal programming language. It is available in many forms like command-based and GUI-based. GUI in the sense, graphical user interface. When we go for command-based programming language, I can give you example as BlueJ, and GUI programming language as Java NetBeans. So today we will be exploring the features of Java NetBeans. So there are different characteristics of Java. The first one is Vora, write once, run anywhere. Like you can run a piece of code, Java code, and run on any platform. So it is a platform independent, we can say. And lightweight code. So in order to accomplish the huge task, I can write a simple code to accomplish that. Security. There are many built-in security features available for Java. Like built-in graphics, there are variety of graphics, inbuilt graphics available in Java. Object-oriented language, it is based on the OOPS concepts where data abstraction, encapsulation, and all the other features of OOPS are used. And it also supports multimedia. Like I can also many graphics, audio, as well as video files. And it's a platform independent. So once I write the code, I will be able to execute on any of the systems, and it is open product. Open product in the sense it will be available freely in the market. So Java NetBeans, I can download it freely and I can use. Now we will see how compilation process. Compilation process in the sense, so whatever we are writing the code is known as source code. So source code is nothing but the high level programming language where we use simple English statements, and in order to make it understand to the system, it should be converted finally to MLL, that is machine level language. So that will be done by language processors like compiler and interpreter. Compiler is a language processor which converts the source code to machine code at once. So once entire code is read and any errors, anything is there, it will be displayed there. Whereas interpreter is the language processor where high level programming language will be converted to machine level programming language line by line. So every line, if at all any error is there, it will be displayed over there. So now the Java compilation process includes both compilation as well as interpretation. So this is how the source code, what we are using Java, and then Java compiler will be used to convert the source code to bytecode. A bytecode is a special code which is similar to machine code, but it is like platform independent. So since if I want to work on Windows operating system, I can have the JVM, Java Virtual Machine. It's a special interpreter which is designed native for the native language here. And Linux also will have JVM. So once the bytecode is generated, it will be able to run on any kind of operating system with the help of JVM. JVM stands for Java Virtual Machine, and it's a special interpreter which converts the bytecode into machine code. Now we'll see what is rapid application development. These are called as RAD tools. These are the tools which will enable to create the application in shorter time. In the sense, all ready-made icons or controls are available to us. It offers many features like creating frames, dragging and dropping the controls onto frames, setting the properties, as well as adding code to handle the events. These are the basic features of RAD tools. So NetBeans IDE will offer a RAD style of developing applications. Now, just we will go to one virtual tour of NetBeans Java IDE. So you need to start all programs, NetBeans and NetBeans IDE. So NetBeans IDE is started downloading now. Next. After it completes the loading, it looks like this, with the menu bar and standard toolbar and the start page. Next. Here, in order to create a new project, click on File, New Project. You will be able to choose like this, Java application. Once you have done this, by default the name will be Java application 1. So you can also change the name by giving your own username. And then after this, it will show you the file project name as well as the source packages as well as libraries. So in order to create a Java frame, you need to right click on this. This will show, once it is created, it will show the source and history page like this. Source code, source is the one where code is written to handle the events. So an event is an occurrence of an activity like mouse click event or key press event, whichever I would like to do it to create the event. Now, in order to create a new frame, you can click on, right click on this new JFrame form. If you click on that, you can see the IDE here. It's already one created IDE. It is here. There are two text fields over here. There are two text fields here. There are two labels and one button. So here, this is a palette, tool palette here. All swing controls are available here. You can check whichever control you want. You can just drag and drop and you can make use of the tools. And each tool, each control will have list of properties. You can again select this, right click and go to properties and change the properties whatever you want. And this is a command button. If I double click on this, the button event will be created. Here is the button action performed is the event. And these are the code lines which I need to create. Since the program now, what you are watching is addition of two numbers. I'm just adding two numbers. Once I run this file, I'll get two text boxes like this, and where I can enter the numbers. And then if I click on button, you will be getting the result. This is the short tour of NetBeans Java IDE. In the next lesson, we'll be learning in detail how to create the Java project. Thank you.